Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday, SpaceX successfully launched their 49th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 658. The booster which launched this mission, B1073, then landed successfully for the 15th time on the drone ship in short full of gravitas.
Stage 2 in terminal guidance.
Landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing.
Then, on Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 50th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 87.
Falcon 9, go Starlink, go SpaceX.
The boost which launched this mission, B1063, then landed successfully for the 18th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
This week we can hopefully expect to see at least another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 659 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 18th at 1:22 a.m. UTC or Friday 17th at 9:22 p.m. EST. There was an article posted about the number of Starlink satellites SpaceX has in orbit now. It says SpaceX launched a batch of 23 Starlink satellites on its Falcon 9 rocket from Cape Canaveral Space Force Station. The mission brings the total number of Starlink satellites to 5,999 satellites in orbit, according to numbers published Sunday by expert orbital tracker and astronomer Jonathan McDowell. Heading to Boca Chica after Ship 30 testing, the Pad B test mount has started being disassembled. Work has begun on scrapping another old orbital tank farm shell. Half of the shell was seen being lifted after being cut. The groundwork for the second orbital launch pad is continuing at Starbase. The work on the new office building has been continuing as well. Starship Gazer posted a picture of a newly designed Starship flap that arrived at Starbase. It says, first Starship Block 2 forward flap spotted during delivery this morning. Felix from What About It also posted a picture of the new flap design from an aerial view so you can see the shape of it. The B14.1 forward dome section was seen being moved around Starbase. After recent heat shield tile work, Starship 29 was rolled to the launch site recently to join Booster 11. It was then rolled over to the orbital launch pad. It was also moved inside the chopsticks to be lifted. During testing of Starship 31 at Massey's test site, it seems there was an electrical issue. Chris Burgin said Ship 31 appears to have suffered an issue during its cryo testing at Massey's. Here's some video of the test where Ship 31 suffered the issues. After the incident, still during testing, a drone was seen inspecting Ship 31. Felix from What About It posted some pictures of Ship 31 after the issue. He said SpaceX's Ship 31 encountered an unknown problem during its last cryo test at Massey's test site at Starbase. Here's the aftermath. Extensive damage to the raceway. To finish up the video today, we'll take a look at the Cameron County website where SpaceX have a possible closure for tomorrow, Thursday 16th. Plus, they also have temporary closures still for Friday 17th, Sunday 19th and Monday 20th. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.